a literal sidewalk available to the public. I'm not trespassing.
Yeah, sure. So there were these people back by Gwazi sitting on the bench in front of Gwazi, and they said, like, is that thing open? One of them said, oh yeah, look, it's built. Of course it's open. It just opens at 11 like everything else. So if you do come here recently, you've probably noticed that there are these red gates around this area. And I thought, oh, well, they're probably just painting. No, I'm actually going to back up from this, because the reason this is here is there's a giant beehive directly behind there. And there's just, you can't see them now, there's a couple of bees flying around, but there's just, yesterday there's just hundreds of bees on that wall. So there's something back there that's attracting the bees. And that's why they put this here, so no one actually disturbs them. But yesterday there was just hundreds of bees all down that wall. So if you come here, steer clear of this. If you're allergic to bees by any chance, there's another way to get around here. Just take the long way, cut off on this. But this is just a warning. If any of you guys have bee allergies, don't come through this pathway. Take the long way, take a right when you come in, and just get to Stanleyville the long way. You know, I'm starting to get addicted to coming to Busch Gardens early in the morning. I mean, just look at how beautiful this is. It's completely empty. No one's around here. It just looks great. And yeah, there are, it's not completely empty, there are people. But this part of the air, this part of the park isn't open yet. I mean, look at this. Yeah, I was right. You can't really see it, but it's 10:29. And it's absolutely beautiful. I'm really the, in this area back here, I'm actually the only one. It's just me, because none of this is technically open yet. So we got this all to ourselves. I am gonna go back towards Kumba, because I do wanna try to get revenge for them blocking me off on the Forgotten. And I do want to get like a off-ride cinematic video on Kumba. I don't think I'll be doing that for Shikra. I'll do that another day, because gosh, it's beautiful. I know this won't be the last time I do this. All right, guys, we got some major new construction going on with the Forgotten. All right, right at the entrance, it looks like someone watched my videos, because we now have two temporary gates at the entrance. That's right, guys, we got two of them. And I just want to make something very clear. When I said, because I know someone at the park, I don't know who's watching my videos at the park, but I know someone at the park is watching my videos, because I know they plugged those walls. I know they did that. And I'm just saying, guys, when I said I was going to get my revenge on you guys for blocking me off, I was joking. I'm not, and my revenge, even if I was being serious, it wouldn't be trespassing. You guys don't have to block me out. I ain't gonna trespass. I ain't gonna go back there. And even if I wanted to, I would just take that one, because you guys are leaving that open. So the sign at the front of the gate was right for once. Tigris does look like it's gonna be closed today. And I just got interrupted by Falcon's Fury. But it does look like Tigris is gonna be closed for the day. We know the Forgotten is, well, there. We'll try to get our updates in later. Maybe another day. That's for another day. It's another excuse to come early morning. But yeah, it doesn't look like we're going to be getting on this today. It's fine. Let's go to Kumba. So with where we are right now, Shikra has officially given its first ride of the day with actual riders. And the log flume isn't even open. It's just all drained right now. This is cool. So if anyone here is actually interested on how log flumes work, we all know how roller coasters have that three-wheel lock system that keeps it on the track. Well, log flumes, when you're going up the lift hill, kind of latch itself onto this. The track usually is like this, and then it kind of bends up like this to keep the car in place. And you can see that right there. That's where it really hooks on right there to keep the car in place. And then it lets go right here and just lets you go back off. So if anyone was wondering how log flumes keep you safe, that's how. All right, so we've arrived at Kumba, and for anyone who doesn't know, and I was aware of this, so it's not like I'm shocked or anything, this ride, well, Kumba doesn't open until 11, and it is 10:39 right now, so we got 20 minutes until this ride opens, and I'm here to shoot some B-roll, baby, so I ain't waiting. I'm just gonna go and just film some video, because there's no chain here. You can still walk up to it. There's nothing actually blocking me, so I'm not trespassing where they don't want me to go at the current time. So yeah, I'm the first one over by Kumba for the day. I love this walk-up music. I don't know when they scored Kumba, but I love it. And I know they probably didn't write this score just for Kumba, but I love it. It's amazing. Just look at this. I can't wait to get some video of this. All right, so two things I want to do before this opens. One, I want to discuss the new house because, well, who doesn't want to talk new houses? And two, I want to shoot some B-roll. We got around 20 minutes or so, so I think we got some time. Let's go over here and talk houses. I was going to go over there and talk about the house, but I've learned based off my last video that I don't want to talk about houses directly next to running water, because that makes editing a literal nightmare. All right, so I don't know if you're able to hear this super dramatic music directly behind me, but if you can, then, hey, it just means I don't have to bother putting music over this video. Just go to their website, Howl-O-Scream Tampa. All right, we're on their website right now. All right, so we're on Haunts and Thrills, our new house. The last time we had the Forgotten as our new house, now we have, and before I say the name, this will be replacing Insomnia. And this is Cell Block Z Zombies. Let's go somewhere else. This music is a bit much. The music is coming from that speaker right there and that speaker right there. So I'm gonna go over here and talk about this. Around right here in this area, I should be good to talk. Yes, this is a lot better. Still completely alone, so let's just talk Cell Block Z Zombies right now. So this will be replacing Insomnia, and this also may be on the list of reasons why they suddenly switched it to three houses and not two, because they realized at the last minute that maybe they were able to change Insomnia over to being this, because it is very similar. However, I could be wrong. They could have been planning this one from the beginning. Let's just start with the description, because this is a bit disturbing, and while there's no one around me, I want to say this. The description is, welcome to Purgatory Penitentiary, where afterlife sentences are served with a vengeance. Incarnation is just the beginning, as maniacal guards shuffle fresh meat down dark and lawless paths for processing. Surviving the prison yard leads to maximum security and confinement that is anything but solitary. There are only two options for inmates here, break out alive or be devoured in detention. Allow me to just be way too nice to Busch Gardens again. As I say, y'all really got a great creative team this year. I don't know who is writing these house themes, but they are not getting paid enough. I'm sure they're being paid well, but it's not enough, because these are some of the most creative themes I've seen in a while. Insomnia was creative. And I know everyone was upset when they found out that Insomnia may be leaving. But if this is what's replacing Insomnia, maybe we don't have any reason to be worried or upset that Insomnia is leaving. Falcon's Fury just scared me so hard I nearly dropped my camera. But this genuinely looks amazing. So let's just take, it's very similar to Insomnia as you see in the trailer, which, by the way, I don't think I put the trailer up yet, so before I get any deeper, and I'm gonna be referencing this, here's the trailer right now. Alright, so, now that we've seen the trailer, one, I think we can tell by the photos that I'm also going to be putting on screen. I'll move my head to the side a bit so you can see that a bit. The sets are very similar to Insomnia. It looks very similar to the past ones that they used to have. So, clearly it's all recycled. It's nothing, like, it's not incredibly different. Could be a reason why it got up to 3 new ones. But who knows? But it does look very similar. So it could be a very similar theme, and it looks like Kumba could be opening soon. So we'll talk about this more when we actually get over towards where it's gonna be. But right now, I think Kumba's about to open. All right, so we just got done shooting Kumba. It's about like maybe an hour later. So I'm just gonna go show you guys what Howl-O-Scream looks like right now for the rest of the video. So we're not gonna worry about writing anything. I'll come back and get the POVs later. But I mean, hey, that's the joy of doing this all the time. Like this, the double layering. Guys, I'm joking. Neil, Schaefer, Itai, whoever's ratting me out here at Busch Gardens, I was joking, I'm not actually gonna break in and get you guys back. That was a joke. Severe lapse of judgment, I'm sorry. Right in front of Sheikra. Just for reference of where we are, that's Sheikra's drop. Boom. Dia Dies Los Muertos. So we know that this zone is coming back. And it's gonna be directly out here in front of Sheikra. And as you can see, they are using it for advertising. All right, directly under Cheetah Hunt. We all know where we are. And this is our second location. This is the only other location that I've spotted. Right now, I think it's only these two, the Dies Los Muertos and whatever this is. It looks like this is gonna be a new one unless they're bringing the shortcut out here, which I don't think they would because the shortcut kind of played off of its own location. So I'm not quite sure what this can end up being, and I'm not 100% sure. Those names look fake, and there's only one letter of a last name, and the dates are pretty ancient if you can't tell. So I don't think that these are actual people's names, and it does seem like these are old props. I mean, this was used back in Dark Side of the Gardens, which was, if you don't know what that was the theme for Howl-O-Scream back in 2011. So this is definitely some old props being used right here. But it is shocking that they are setting this stuff up this early, but yet again, they are using it for advertisement, so I won't say it's the worst idea. So what's going on with the residents? Well, it's exactly what you would expect. I'm sorry, my hand's a little shaky. I'm just like holding it up. But yeah, like really nothing. Nothing has changed. Because I mean, they don't have to do much. And so here we are, Deathwater Bayou. I think that it's definitely skeptical as of now if this one is still returning. I know in the last video I predicted that it would be rethemed to a different name, but very similar. However, I'm starting to rethink that now, and I think this could have a possibility of returning. However, we'll get into that in a little bit. We'll check out the website. Well, we gotta go meet someone real quick, so we'll be right back. Adam spotted. Dang it, I was gonna freaking stand. House hunting. We've been everywhere except for the new house location.
Location's Insomnia.
Yeah, Insomnia. I just haven't been over that way. I've been to every other house location except for Insomnia.
Well, you got cell block zombies now or something?
I'm just gonna call it cell block Z. Cell block zombies is a mouthful, and I don't know, it doesn't sound as cool.
I feel like they've done that before, honestly.
Yeah, it's a zombie containment unit part 2.
Yeah, it is.
Yeah. Except for, please don't be any guns. Please don't try that again. That did not work. It did not work the first time. So earlier, when I was recording there, they had this blue forklift, and they were just driving this huge white and gray wall into the house.
Over there?
Yeah, over there. I caught it behind. I mean, I don't know how well you're able to see it on video, but I did catch that when we were walking by. Again, this one's really hard to film because of the lighting, but there's people back there working. So something is going on, that's for sure. It's really hard to see. but there are people back there. Oh, they're moving something. It's really large and gray. It looks like an entire wall. Yeah, they're moving something. They got a car back there. Not a themed car, it's a like a forklift. They just moved something absolutely massive, but it's gray, almost whitish.
Yeti, like I said, I was thinking Yeti, but like I don't know anymore.
Yeah, I feel like Yeti's kind of not.
Well, if you think, it's not like Busch Gardens theme, but like, yeah, if it's snow, if it was like a snowy like background.
Yeah,
I'm still thinking Yeti. I'm still gonna think Yeti.
I'm thinking more of, because I like the snow idea. You ever heard of the Hateful Eight?
Yeah.
I'm thinking something like the Hateful Eight, kind of like blizzard trapped in a cabin type.
Okay. Yeah.
I mean, we don't get snow in Florida,
I mean,
we don't get snow in Florida, so that'd be pretty supernatural. So
snow machines.
Yeah, and then they would have everything out for Christmas Town. They wouldn't have to do anything.
They wouldn't.
Yeah, they wouldn't. Are there any like besides Yeti, like ice, mythical like zombies or vampires, or like is there anything like that related to snow or ice besides Elsa? I genuinely cannot find anything. So who knows? Where are we at?
Cell block, zombies.
Yes, we are at zombies now. What's in there? What's in there?
Tarts.
Wow.
Tarts.
Are you kidding me? An open door. I cannot see what's in there.
Hello?
There's pallets and paint. You know, I am a bit curious if I can just like. Where is Adam? He is all the way over there. Great.
They don't worry about me.
Yeah, I know they don't worry about you, but what are these walls here for?
Trash cans.
These walls are massive. Like, what the heck? What in the frick are you?
There's walls back there.
There's more walls? Wait, is there gonna be an outdoor section? Because they did say something about the, they did say something about a courtyard.
I didn't read the description, honestly.
Yeah. There's walls. There's literally walls. They're extending on the exit.
Welcome to the Purgatory Penitentiary, where afterlife sentence are served with a vengeance. Acceleration is just the beginning as nothing about a courtyard.
Dang.
Oh no, surviving the prison yard leads to maximum security.
The prison yard.
He doesn't like me talking.
Schaefer cut you off. All right, now I'm confused.
I'm confused
because the walls. Yeah, the walls were right here. I'm officially confused. Wait, then what's in here? Oh, they're just paving the ground over. It looks like they're just doing pathway work. This dude. His head against. Your head against the wall is just gonna be the thumbnail. So, I wasn't recording, but when we were climbing up to the Serengeti Cafe, I saw that one of the things underneath a tarp in there is this giant box-like thing. I'm not sure what it is. It may be a sign.
Sign. I'm hoping for a facade. It looks like they're building a facade, but they don't do facades for their houses. So, I mean, the residents, they did like a kind of like.
They did facade. An outdoor indoor thing.
Yeah.
You entered the house through the garage indoors. So I think.
Yeah, you went for the garage.
Alright, so final house predictions. Since we know the Forgotten's coming back.
Well, no, the Forgotten's new.
The
it's
new Forgotten's
back.
New. Wow.
Okay.
Wow. Okay. I'm leaving. No, we have the Forgotten, and then we have Cell Block, which is right behind us, right here, and then we know that whatever is gonna be where Motel Hell is, That's new, which we know will be, like, which will say, we don't know this, because I know how easily some of you guys take rumors and act like they're real.
They're not real.
They're not real. These are just speculations, plot twists. We are not professionals out here. We saw something that looks like a balcony, so that's very possible. But that also confirms that Deathwater Bayou and the residents are both returning. We know Deathwater Bayou is gonna have that werewolf infestation like Freddy versus Jason style.
Oh yeah, yeah, for sure.
And that's like,
I wanna go back there.
I'm intrigued for that. No, that's like the one house we can't record because it's so far back there. And then the residence is just gonna be the residence. I know you're plotting to break in. I know you're plotting. Okay, turns out there was confusion on what time that I'm actually leaving at, so I just gotta go.
Apparently
my ride has been here for like 10 minutes and I had no idea because I'm an idiot. So we got our updates and whatever. All right. I'm not even gonna bother with some fancy outro. I'm just turning this off. We'll do something next week.
So much you